Okay, then, so for those who heard my earlier talk, so what I described earlier was the system we have in production right now, and we're working on what we are, I'm showing now is what we are planning or working on right now how to sort of replace or extend the system that we have. So this is all open source feedback, including the name. I'm really bad at naming things, so if you think at least the name sucks, please come up with a better suggestion. So this is our attempt to make HPC services accessible to everyone, so they can create their own services. But let's do a short recap. So we had seen the slide for a moment because we didn't have time to explain it earlier. Effectively, we have sort of ad hoc implemented an SLURM scheduling system that keeps our SLURM jobs up and running or schedules new jobs which are short running. We have this keep alive script. We are SSH that triggers this scheduler and this proxy system outside. And so, but this has, well, it's working well, but it has some limitations. For example, we noticed like for any model that's like 70 billion parameters or bigger, it takes like a significant amount of time for them to start, like a half a minute, or for bigger models, I think for the 144 billion parameter model for Mixtral, it took like multiple minutes for it to load into memory because it needs like four GPUs to run. So this is not feasible with these short running jobs, so we need to have some other solution. And we also get a lot of people who want to fine-tuning to run their own models, or we want to also consider stuff that isn't LLMs, like any other, like Stable Fusion or whatever people make with machine learning. And they just want to have a place where they can upload their model, create an endpoint, and then they can query against their model. So this is the goal of where we want to go with this. So we want also want to, this also should support critical infrastructure, so we have this multiple service level idea where we can have this stuff more reliable setup. So we have this customer the submission of models. It needs to be sufficient security isolation because of course we don't trust our customers, and our customers shouldn't have to trust each other. So we need to have some level of isolation. We still need to respect this SSH limitation, and end-to-end encryption is also something that my boss really wants to us to implement here, as well as other features like accounting, geo-redundancy, and so on. So we're not building this on SLURM, like we're not that insane, so we're using Kubernetes now. And with that, I came up with this idea for the scalable Kubernetes inference platform, or short SKIP, the terrible name I mentioned. So the idea is that we run two clusters, one for the front-end part and one for the back-end part. The front-end, and they are both connected via this SSH tunnel. The back-end has all the GPU clusters, and it's just doing back-end stuff, so it doesn't even need to be aware of what user is doing a request necessarily. The front-end does the user authentication, API, a key authentication, and all that stuff, and just forwards it to the back-end. To keep it all nice and infrastructure as code, we just use FluxCD and have this all stuff in the repository. But for the front end to discover what services should exist on the back end, we then can do some parsing on these YAML files to create services on the front end. Also, we're looking to work with Hanover to do active-active failover via geo-redundancy for the back ends. And in the end, there should be an automatic workflow for more model service creation to a ready-made API. So I made this wonderful graphic for this. So on the right side, we have everything that's in our HPC system. That's all secure and isolated. And there's only this SSH channel going out and a small input from our GitLab to our internal system. On the left side is the other cluster, which is this HPC web service pool, which runs on VMs without GPUs. And then we use some API gateway to map these services from the front end to the back end. So we can use an SSO authentication for registered customers or API keys with user applications for external customers that we are not even aware of. So to keep things back to containers, we had already talked a bit about container runtime selection, because we want this high qualitative security isolation. And containerd is fine as a high-level runtime, but 1c isn't sufficient for us. So we looked around what our options are there. So the major ones are Qatar Containers, Firecracker, gVisor. Looking at the feature compatibility, Qatar Containers can't do dynamic resource allocation, Firecracker can't do GPUs, gVisor can do both, mostly. Need to verify a bit about it still, but so we will try to use gVisor since it's effectively only one that does it, and in our performance tests, there's no meaningful difference. But for some reason, Firecracker was really slow in the test. So, as one bonus fact, our whole cluster uses Werewolf containers at this point. So we're building the base images that our cluster is running on using Docker files that are then run by Werewolf. Werewolf is a system where we can, we're using Pixieboot to serve images for the compute nodes. So they're built with Podman and then served via Werewolf. And this means that all of our compute nodes in the cluster earlier have no local persistent storage. So in theory, if our whole system does get hacked, so if this SSH channel does get reverse checked or whatever, someone finds a way in, we can pull the plug, reboot everything, and all gets wiped. And we just rebuild the cluster from the GitLab repository, and there's nothing left on the cluster from what's actively running there. And as long as the copper cables don't melt from the massive power draw from all nodes rebooting at once, this is in theory a complete wipe of the cluster to get out any attacker that we have in there. So, and to close off, this is now well, my proposal or what we're working towards for the scalable inference platform. Solves everything in theory, still need to look whether it actually does. And we're in the process of setting this up, and I hope if you have any comments or additions about these ideas, feel free to bring it up, even about the name. And since we are mostly a HPC center of Slurm admins, wish us some luck in maintaining such a Kubernetes beast.